to Outer Zone overnight.
So where do you hail from?
I'm the Ozo representative for Orange County. Beautiful Costa Mesa, California.
So tell me about Outer Zone overnight. How many adventures have you been on?
Gosh, three, and every one of them goes to an even better location. You know, usually a lot of them have been desert-based, as you can see. We have a penchant for finding, recent areas of civilization that have been kind of abandoned or left to rot. So, and they're always in fascinating places, the middle of the desert and beautiful Southern California. I'm going to say this is the majestic Carrizo Gorge. It's an earthquake fault. It's below Anza Borrego and north of the California-Mexico border.
And tell me about the hike.
It's a pretty good hike. I think we're doing about 6 miles up to this point. This is the Carrizo Gorge trestle, the highest and widest curving wooden trestle in the United States. And we just came across its rickety 350-something feet of it, feeling the wood shake beneath our feet. Very intriguing. Very exciting. Did a little overnight. Stayed on some abandoned railed cars.
So you've been on three adventures?
I think so.
Tell me about the second one.
The second event that I attended was in near Lancaster in an abandoned Air Force base that was once served as a federal prison. And we did quite a bit of extensive bit of scouting all through there, the various the workshops, the old radar base, the bunker, the barracks and all that, and it was a good full day.
I know Outer Zone Overnight likes to stress the members educating each other on skills. Have you learned or taught any?
The Outer Zone Overnight gang has quite a bit of varied skills. People come from all sorts of businesses or skill sets. We've got professional hikers and campers and outdoorsmen, and then we have city people, and we have people who know how to shoot bow and arrows, and we have riflemen and all kinds of stuff. So yesterday morning, before we came out to the fantastic Carrizo Gorge, we had a little 5-minute dissertation on the 7 or 8 different kinds of venomous snakes that live in this area.
Like there,
right around there in the crevices under the rocks over here beneath the abandoned railroad cars, all kinds of good stuff like that. So there was nothing in the lecture about the good snakes that don't try to kill you, just all the ones that do want to, you know.
Well, is there a need to hear about the snakes that aren't going to kill you?
Well, I don't know. I guess treating all snakes as though you should run away from them is probably the best bet.
It's a smart bet.
Yeah. Future Outer Zone adventures might be, something in the mountains, maybe? Maybe something not in a desert, or in a beach kind of thing or something like that. I think there was some talk about maybe doing an alpine snow event, which brings a whole different set of survival skills. You know, I think this group's pretty familiar with their desert stuff because we have a lot of Burning Man attendees here. We got some good hikers who do alpine stuff. That might be good. Of course, it's not all campouts and, zombies and stuff like that. There's also some social stuff. You know, I talked about the archery training that was actually in an urban setting in an archery place. And the idea was, well, should something happen, at some point you might run out of bullets. So why not? How about we have some arrows? Let's make some bows and arrows. Let's learn how to do that. So far, most of the Outer Zone Overnight thing we've been doing for the last year and a half have been kind of San Diego-based by the officers are all based out of San Diego. But everyone in the group's been invited to, build up their own scenarios and go to different places or find places to go to, or a social event or a training situation. So this is not a top-down kind of hierarchy. Everyone has kind of equal say in things. And if you've got an interesting skill set that you think people would do well in a situation like this, then we'd like to hear from you. Look, we got to get back across this bridge. So, it was beautiful seeing you guys. Ciao.